I'm talking to LeBron right now. What are you going to show us on Friday that you haven't already tried in these past three games, bro? What are you going to do? You got nothing.
First of all, it's Jordan, but two, his team is ass, literally.
Question's wrong, right? I mean,
it was kind of a cool question. Dude, chill, man. That's you, David, right?
Sorry about that.
No, that's you, man. It's always, man, chill.
But yeah, it also further proves my argument that Kyrie and Kevin Love are overrated dudes.
Ouch. It's kind of hard to say about Kyrie, though, man.
I mean, he's a great scorer, but yeah, that's about it.
Yeah, I think Kyrie's fine. I mean, LeBron made him better, obviously. Kevin Love, I think Kevin Love suffered in the least way. He's been the best of better than Bosh, but just like Boss, like Kevin Love suffered, and it was very tough to find his role, which was kind of ridiculous because he was able to rebound. Like, that was part of his credit, you know? That was never Boss's thing, but that was part of his credit. The dude was getting like 13. So the fact he wasn't able to keep something, like at least 10, but it looked like definitely since year one, he definitely acclimated more, you know?
Yeah.
But I mean, yeah. I think Kyrie, like, LeBron helped Kyrie because he was like, oh, you got to do a score now. And he was like, well, that's all I ever did, buddy. You know? So.
It was crazy, though, but.
But yeah, what was the score today?
What was it? 118-113.
Yeah, the 113 is the only number I remember now.
Because it's been a recurring number for him.
Has it? Oh, that's what you were naming before, right?
Yeah, game one, the Warriors scored 113. Game two and three, the Cavs scored 113. Dude, this game. Last podcast I said that I thought the Warriors were going to win this one. They got close. They got close. I mean, I said that the Cavs were going
to
win this one.
Yeah, I was about to say. I was like, yeah.
I think the last podcast I said that Warriors would win this game, right?
I think you did.
Okay.
I was trying to be against everybody and say Cavs.
What did I say? Did I say Warriors too?
I don't think you gave a result because you're a coward.
I think I always end up saying, like, well, what I would say on paper is there's no reason for the Cavs to win any games. So.
Yo, you say that like five times a podcast.
Well, is it not a fact? I mean, right? Is that not what's happening right now?
I mean, he's not wrong about that. So yeah.
Literally, like KD was like, "Oh fuck, man, I can't let AB be wrong." He just walked up to the 3-point line. My man walked up to the 3-point line like he was just going to work. Like, oh man, it's like what? It's 4:59. Oh shit, let me get serious. You know, it's just like
he was like, "I want to hear Stephen A's mouth right now."
Yeah.
Yo, I heard his mom had some words for Stephen A. Smith, though, because she was on First Take or some shit like that.
I don't watch that, so what is he talking about KD that his mom would be angry? Like, what is he even saying?
He basically badmouthed him. He said, like, ever since he went to Golden State, he was like, that's the weakest move from a superstar, that he doesn't have the balls to win a title.
What?
Well, isn't he about to win a title right now?
Yeah. No, he said it's like within the last year. And
what is wrong with people? Like this is what I'm this stupid argument of, like, how dare you team up with people? I'm like, if anything, like first of all, you know how I feel about winning. So I feel all these people are doing the right thing. But second off, don't we groom these kids to do that again in college and in grade ball and high school and everything? All they do is go play with their good friends, you know?
Yeah.
You know, most of them don't stay with Kaká teams like LeBron did. You know, maybe that's why LeBron and Curry had that power, because they went to bad teams. Curry went to a bad college. I don't know about his high school, but his college, I mean, come on. I haven't seen that college since.
No, right? You know, like, they retired his jersey recently, too, I think.
They should. And right? That's the only reason we know they exist. And then the other guy was LeBron, same thing. Like, I've never heard of that high school since. You know, like, but most of these kids, man, like, they meet each other in the All-Americans. And like, yo, let's all go to Duke. Let's all go to Kentucky. Let's all go to blah, 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 you know? Ain't nobody like Dwayne Wade. Like, yo, I want to go to Marquette, you know, where all the champions are at. Like, what? You know? So, I mean, like, they've been groomed this way. Like, the only thing, money comes in now. But, again, if you're smart enough to realize, like, yo, man, did you know, like, $3 million can probably buy what $10 million can buy. You're like, you know, like, then like, I'm gonna just go play with Curry. He seems pretty cool. Like, you know what he does? He passes the ball. Like, this is crazy. He's oh, you know what? Check it out. When he shoots, they go in too. I ain't never had that before.
Always win 60 games a year. It's crazy.
He shoot from the logo, still goes in. That's crazy. Why don't you try that, Westbrook? Oh. You know, like,
don't you touch that basketball. That's my basketball. Don't you touch it.
That's Westbrook to KD.
Yeah, what's wrong with these people saying, oh, I hate the NBA. GS ruined it for me. He said, I'm not going to watch the NBA again until they split up. I'm like, what?
Yeah, a lot of people be talking about that. And I'm like,
he's talking about the asses. That's why.
That's people just, I don't know, man. People be taking sports like mad seriously. In this weird way, and I'm like, yo, if they did that for your team, let me tell you, because for pretty much historically, this only one team did this, and that was the Yankees. You know, and you know what? The Yankees did it the reverse way, because they had an owner who gave a shit. Versus now, people choose to do it. You know, because most of those players never wanted to play for the Yankees. Like, maybe some of them had childhood dreams, but of them, and all, yeah, he got drafted. He's had a different story. But I mean, like, a lot of them come over.
Wanted to play the Yankees, you know, growing up in Jersey and stuff.
Yeah, but a lot of them come over and they're like, "Yeah, I had a childhood dream," and I'm like, "Yeah, right, man. You just took that 6-5 year contract for a triple digit, you know, figure. That's what their dream. You know, I mean, like, most of those guys come over to the Yankees. There, none of them ever go like, can't wait to be a free agent and go to the Yankees. They only come when the Yankees bought them out. But now people are choosing to do it on purpose. You know, so it's like, shut up, dude. Because all those people who work a shitty-ass job complaining would probably be like, man, if Google came calling or Facebook or something sexy, they'd probably leave. You know what I mean? They'd probably leave tomorrow. You know what I mean?
No loyalty.
Yeah.
No. Like, Laker fans have no – like, if Laker fans are bitching about this, they have no reason to argue. The Lakers have been, like, 52 finals, so, yeah. Or 33, I think.
Hey, man, but they're – they were also another product of an owner who gave a shit, so that might be tough from now on. I guess now that Magic Johnson is kind of maybe there, but Magic Johnson needs to prove his worth, and he also needs to keep on battling the family, because it looks like the family is not ready to concede power amongst itself either.
Agreed.
So. Oh, hell yeah. Yeah, Jerry Buss would have gave him a share if he was still alive.
Yeah.
But much we call it. Speaking of Lakers, Lonzo Ball was practicing for the Lakers. LaVar Ball wasn't part of it at all.
I heard that. That's crazy. We want your son, not you. Get out of here.
Hey, by all means.
I know Davis said. Do you know anything about that kid? You think he can ball, Danny?
What about Lonzo?
Yeah.
Man, I don't know. I don't watch that college ball stuff. I've seen some highlights. I guess, you know, it kind of, from the highlights, honestly, I've never seen his college highlights. I've only seen the high school highlights of the three ball kids. And honestly, in high school, it just looks like they were just playing really, you know, subpar other high school teams more than it looked like them being nice. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
So I don't know. I'm waiting for the NBA game one, you know, next season. We'll see.
Yeah, we will see.
Yeah, I guess I'll be playing a lot of basketball this summer.
Who, you?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know. Just wanted to let you know.
You
just
ready
just
to sign up for the Warriors?
Nah. I heard about that. Like
on the Warriors roster, they just handing them out. You get one.
Word.
I'm like, what?
Well, yeah, like I was. Gonna...
I was like,
nah. I mean, I gotta keep busy after this off season. So
why
yeah.
Why don't you do something? Why don't you make some rap albums or something, dude? Like,
do hey, I'll probably even do that. I'll probably even do that too.
I mean, I love basketball. I don't know why y'all keep spending so much time on it though. Ain't nobody turning pro off of that shit, you know?
Bro, I'm way past. I'm way too late for that.
Yeah, man.
So. Yeah, you never know what if there's a lockout thing again.
Oh,
no,
man.
The replacements.
I don't think it's going to be another lockout again.
Maybe Whoopi Goldberg will be the coach of the New York Knicks and stuff. You never know.
Yeah.
Hmm.
But, yeah, but what? So I missed this game, but David texted me around the second quarter, and then Danny did. What were the first two quarters like when they seemed to. David texted me, but then he told me to score, and I was like, but that seems like the Cavs are doing the best they've done so far. But because David texted me in the second quarter, and he's like, yo, it looked like the Warriors are going to win, and I thought it was another blowout, and the score was like, you know, like 40 this, 40 that, and I was like, that's the best they've done, like this whole
season. No, in the first quarter, they had 39 points. So that's what I'm saying, like, it might go to the Warriors, and then... Like as the game went on, it was at a faster and faster pace.
Yeah,
I'm like, yo, and then I was yelling at the TV. I'm like, yo, do not shoot a three right now. Then Curry just drove it. I'm like, my guy. And then Durant took a three. I'm like, okay.
This game then, was close for like pretty much the whole thing. And there's another moment in the fourth quarter. He didn't do three like he did last time, but yeah, where LeBron got the ball and he took a three, and I'm like. I get it, man, but, you know, chill. Like, I don't remember the exact circumstances under, but he took it, and I was just like, man, you know, just why? You know, like, don't do it. You know, like I know it's tempting, man, but that's fool's gold, man. Like, what's LeBron's three for this series? You know, I bet you it's not good.
No, it's definitely not. I don't... like,
you mean his three-point shot?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, it has to be good because he was hitting him in this game. Let me.
I don't know. I mean, I just.
Just give me a second. Let me just do this research real quick.
It just seems like from the little bit I watched, like they are not. That's not what they should be doing. Like, it seems tempting because the other team does it, like, for no reason and in people's faces, you know? And all the time and a lot of the time, you know? like, but you guys try that and it's just, like, not good. You know what I mean? Like, so don't do that. You know, like, I get it. Like, it seems easy. And that's literally how... That's what I was saying. That shit probably feels demoralizing because the Cavs are playing so good and then the Warriors, like, that's cool. Three-pointer, you know? Like, that's cool. Three-pointer, you know? And, like, we're still here, you know? That's cool. Like you can keep getting 2-for-1 baskets, but three pointer, and just three pointer. That shit wears you down. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, never. Well, damn. Let me see what. So
it
well,
is
in
bad,
the two
right? I told you. Like,
and the last two games, he shot 33%. Let me see what he shot in this game.
Has to be down in this one.
No, I've seen him hit a couple, but I'll see what it is.
I mean, I feel like 33% sounds better than I thought he was doing.
He shot 4-for-9 on threes in this game.
Oh, I'll take that back.
I mean, that doesn't sound too bad.
I must have seen just the five misses. Must have been the ones
right? That's what I'm saying. Like, but you see, and we might not be wrong. Like, maybe those misses might have happened at the...
crucial moments?
Yeah, and that's why I remember that. Because it'd just be looking like... Man, like, why'd you, like, on the one hand, man, he's like a star, so stars could, for moments, break out, so I get it, man, but it just be looking like, nah, dude, don't do that, you know, do something else, you know, like, just, that's not the move for you, you know? They lost this game by LeBron potentially attempting a three.
I agree. He took a late three. It was just like, why?
Oh, I don't even mean the three of that. I mean the one with Iggy, right? Where he snaps it out.
Right, but I don't think he was going to take a three. I don't think he was.
Well, no, he definitely was.
He didn't have to, but time is running out. So that's what I'm saying. He might have been ready to take that.
I always think that he's even when he's lined up for a shot, he's always thinking to pass it out to someone else for the three. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know.
Yeah, but that's in the corner. You don't got many options there, too.
Yeah, but this man has made incredible passes throughout his career. So it's like I can't ever doubt that he can't make a crazy pass from that spot, you know?
That's true. How many points did he have today?
30-something.
LeBron had 39.
What do you think? What do y'all think happens game four?
Oh, they win the title in Cleveland. Like, I said it might be a route.
I know. To end. Oh, wow. So you don't even think LeBron. Do you even think they're going to fight back?
No. I always said this. I expect the best from LeBron. Nothing less at this point. Everybody else I have no faith in. So, it might be a route.
Yeah, I asked this question early, Danny, just less for, like, the answer and more, like, what do you think they're going to play like? Like everybody, you know? Like,
I mean, you know, David said it earlier, honestly. Like, honestly, I expect it maybe to be similar to the game we just watched. If not, more... All right, let me reword this. I think the Warriors are going to win, and I think LeBron's going to do everything in his power to try to win, but the rest of his team is going to disappoint him. And like David said, the Warriors are going to sweep them and be champions and set NBA records like they always do and stuff like that. So,
like they always do.
So this question begs, are the Warriors, if they win on Friday, I don't want to say win because last year, that's why, would you consider them the greatest team ever?
Still kind of early for that, isn't it? I think it's still kind of early before saying something like
that. No, I mean, like, this year's Golden State team.
Oh, best Golden State team ever?
No, he means best team ever.
Best team
like
ever?
The 2017 Warriors, like, are they the greatest team ever?
You'd have to compare them to... You can't even... Honestly, I wouldn't even compare them to any of Michael Jordan's teams.
It's weird, right?
You'd have to go further back, I would... Well, yeah,
you could. Like, I was thinking, like, the 80s, the Lakers in the
80s. Lakers and Celtics, those teams, because those are the teams that had, like, the crazy amount of, you know, all-stars starting, you know what I mean?
Why wouldn't you compare them to Jordan's teams?
Because we all know that it was just Jordan. Do you think Jordan really would have been able to take on the Warriors? That would have been
maybe. Other people talk other stuff about Jordan.
And I don't mean to disrespect the great one. Look, I don't mean any disrespect by the great one. I respect him.
I believe Jordan's power, as I say time and time again, was willpower. So I believe for the purposes of these games, I wouldn't be surprised if he could hang around, dude. Like,
But you said hang around, though.
Well, if he hangs around, like, that's all he ever did was hang around and then, like, win it at the end with game winners, you know? But I mean, like...
So does KD?
Dude, but I just would expect Jordan to get, like, 60-plus every game. Like, facts. that's facts. I honestly, there's no reason on earth why he would... Like, because I would expect the pace to be, like, you know, stupid. So I expect Jordan's like, y'all really want to do this? And he would probably be in that ass, you know?
Come on, like, man! Ain't nobody. What? I don't know.
No, nah, well, Scotty's definitely buzzard meat when it comes to guarding KD.
Last I checked, Boston beat the Bulls, right? 3-0. Good Boston. Last I checked, Michael Jordan got 59 in game one, and then Larry Bird said, "Chill, you ain't never doing that again." And then he got 63 in game two. And then he said, "All right, my bad. He's God in sneakers, you know." So I mean, those are like other teams. Like, these are people who like they kill the shot. You know, like they have D'Antoni philosophy. Like there was moments in this game where like they're behind and the Warriors were just shooting like 2 or 3 seconds. You know, and Jordan is not a 3-pointer unless the power compels him to be one. You know, where he starts shoulder slugging. Jordan, there's no reason Jordan would just run up, layup, run up, dunk, and run up mid-range. And you know that mid-range is like Curry for three. You know what I mean?
All I'm trying to say is, I don't include Jordan in it because I don't think he has the personnel to keep that his team has the personnel to keep up with the Warriors. If we were doing the whole comparing different, and let me say one more thing, Jordan never faced another offense like this ever. No,
you're
one
right. You're right, but like I just think he would adapt to it. I think he would just. He'd be all right. I believe he'd be all right.
I'm just saying, I would take one of the Laker teams that are stacked with all stars, or one of the Celtics teams.
I'm a big believer in Jordan and anybody. You know that. You know what?
I wouldn't even the bad boy, the Pistons. I don't even think they would be able to hang with these guys either.
Oh no!
What team?
It depends what rules we're playing with. Because if we're playing in the 80s,
that's true.
like they might not be able to hang. But Curry, we don't gotta hang with Curry if he's on the bench because he can't walk.
Oh,
you know, that's why I said it depends. What it depends because we playing with their rules, they'd be like, "Oh man, Curry needs to get in that gym, don't he? You know, he seems to be not be able to hang like us real men. You know, I don't know what's wrong with him. You know, either that or like they just better only shoot threes, like just only, like don't even drive. You know, and then even then you might still get tackled on that 3-point line.
Nah, he was getting hit in this game. I'm like, what the fuck? Like, and he wasn't even getting any calls in this game.
This game
like,
was physical.
Mm. Yeah, it definitely was.
They're trying to help the Cavs out, dude. Make it an even series.
Yeah.
I can't find Iggy. My home.
Yeah, Iggy was real clutch with that swipe, though.
Yo, I thought it was a foul. I was so surprised that it was clean.
You know, other steal was crazy when Steph stripped LeBron when he was about to drive.
I thought that was a foul, too, but that looked pretty clean. Was it clean?
Nah, it was real clean. I'm like, oh, shit. That's what I knew was about to be over. I'm like, damn, I never seen anybody strip LeBron like that.
Yeah. I don't think LeBron even felt like he was there. Like, he probably thought that this guy was just, like, slacking off and not chasing him down.
He definitely remembers last year when he was talking shit to him in his face, calling him a little nigga.
Oh, man, yo, he was mad disrespectful last year, though.
Wait, who did what?
LeBron was mad disrespectful when he got that block on Curry.
Oh, what'd he say?
Called him a little nigga.
Did he really say that?
Yeah, he did.
They show that replay all the time. You could read it. Like, you could read his lips. He's saying it.
I didn't know LeBron had trash talk in him. That's funny.
Yeah, he was talking mad fucking shit, like, from last year's finals until, like, the season opener and shit, like, the Halloween shit with the 3-1 cookies.
Oh, I remember that.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I think I hear even when he does those locker room talks, he wears a t-shirt making fun of whoever he's facing and stuff.
Oh, he had an Ultimate Warrior shirt?
I've heard that before. He has a sick t-shirt game.
I mean, it's that's good, but I mean, like, facts is facts, yo. Like, you know, like, I don't know, hit some threes, you know, this is the wrong team to be.
More like, don't miss your threes.
Yeah.
Hard. Well, listen, man, I think it might be past my time. You know, the day job beckons.
This is a baby podcast over here.
Yeah, man, I'm gonna leave it to y'all too.
We know what's gonna happen anyway. This might as well be the last podcast for the NBA season. This thing is done.
Are we not even gonna do one for game four?
Why? We already know who won.
I mean, you never know, though. But yeah.
When is game four? It better not be Sunday. I won't hear nobody telling me it's Sunday. When?
It's on Friday.
Damn, they changed the whole schedule. Now it's Wednesday and Friday. What's wrong with people?
Yeah, they do. They do that like when the road team gets home court advantage. So, like, in this case, like, when they shift venues from Oakland to Cleveland, that's how they do it, apparently.
Still stuck in the old days, the Tuesday, Thursdays, Sundays.
I don't mind those days.
And I used to fuck with the 2-3-2 format in the finals.
That was stupid. Mm-hmm. I always thought that was dumb. I felt like, why would you change it for one and not for all of them? You know what I mean? Like,
right.
Yeah, that was dumb. All right, so I can't wait till
I'm done with this NBA Finals podcast. I can't wait for the next podcast we do where we talk about all the NBA awards. That's the one I really want to talk about.
Yeah, so wait, real quick, y'all. Are they doing the awards after the finals?
Yep.
Because this is going to be the least important awards ever. Like, who cares? The season's done. Like, why do we need to backtrack?
Like, we're like, KD got the last laugh on his former teammates.
Like,
who cares?
Like, you didn't win, you know? You know, like, at least, like, when they got it before, there was the optimism and hope of, like, you know, he might still do something, but this is.
Wow. This shit is literally 3 weeks away.
What, the announcement?
Yeah, the awards.
Oh my god!
It's the last week of June on Monday. Last Monday.
Yeah, who cares about that? Like by then, like who cares?
Like deadass.
Oh man, that's stupid. All right, so here we'll try to wrap it up real quick. This will be like shortest podcast ever.
sorry guys.
It's your idea to do this too, man. But to be fair, I killed a lot of time fixing shit.
Or trying to be fix fair. It.
Yeah.
The Warriors did all the work already. I mean. There's nothing to be said.
Let's try to wrap that. Let's do this. So Friday is over, everybody.
Yeah, I can see that happening.
Valiant effort by the Cavs, but again, get your broom and your dustpan ready.
Bird.
Damn. Alright. It was. Or how about this? Hashtag never forget. The Warriors blew a 3-0 lead. Is that coming? Is that coming?
Come on, man. Even if they had four chances to win one. They had four more games to try to win one.
Look, well, they had three chances to try to win one, right?
All right, well, maybe they needed that one more chance.
There's 2 days in between game four. The NBA has plenty of time to suspend Draymond Green. So yeah, I mean, it's still hope. Adam Silver, like you told me, was actually watching this, so you know he might notice a play. There. Yeah, he might notice a play. Like Curry, you shot a three from half court. That's illegal. Come on, you don't read the rules. You know, like you suspended.
Suspended for the next three games.
Like what?
Sorry.
Who knows? Maybe the refs will call everything on all the Warriors, and then they just not allowed to sweep. So
that'd be hilarious.
But
rigged.
All right, last thoughts and then we'll go say stuff, David, about the series and how it made your life better.
What?
I'm gonna reiterate it and say Kyrie Irving is overrated.
Wow. Bars. I'm gonna go ahead and say that I'm interested to see what the general manager of the Cavs what players he's going to pick up during the offseason.
Oh, man. So that would be curious to see what LeBron does in the offseason. Yes.
Because he needs help. Help. Mm. He should put out a help wanted sign right outside the stadium.
Oh, man. You think LeBron's going to trade Tyronn Lue as well?
Yes.
Oh, man. They're all coming. They're all coming.
We're rebuilding.
All right. I guess we're done.
That's it.
All right. Bacon in your face.